everybody. It's Miss Willow. Today I wanted to take some time for my pet millipedes. As you can see, Clementine here. She has beautiful gold stripes all over her body. She is a golden desert millipede, and she comes from places like Texas and Arizona and down south, areas like that, and can endure very harsh climates, which is extremely impressive for a millipede. But I have multiple different species of giant millipede, which I raise and keep as my pets. So without further ado, today is the day where I clean out their enclosure and I redecorate for them. Yes, I decorate like a little house for them. And they do get rugs to walk on, but they also get substrate to dig in, which is very important for their health. They need that humidity in order to survive because their tracheal systems have no waxy cuticle around them. So the air that comes in dries them out really quickly. So they need humidity. And the soil or substrate helps make that possible for them to maintain that humidity that they so need. So I will show you guys the process of my cleaning out their enclosure for the month of November. Follow me. I will start by introducing Clementine. Clementine you saw before, she is my desert gold millipede. If I can put her down, typically the desert millipedes let me handle them a lot better than the African millipede or the American millipede. And I have a blue Philippine millipede, which is a very rare sought after species in the trade and in the bug collecting hobby. As you can see, Clementine is very adventurous. She loves to explore, and she is typically alongside her, I call it her sister, the chocolate desert millipede, Tara. They are cuddle buddies, and they come from around the same place too. But they typically are topsoil millipedes. Depending on where they are from and the weather conditions that they have to look out for, they have different requirements for digging and burrowing. And typically the desert millipedes like to hang out on the top, so you'll see them a lot more frequently than like the American millipede, who is used to warming up by digging into logs and hiding inside of logs and inside of the dirt. This is Clementine's quote-unquote sister, Tara. Tara is a chocolate desert millipede, and she is also equally an adventurer. I find the two of them cuddling up and coiling up together to rest, which is super, super cute. And millipedes are very slow, hesitant, very cautious creatures, as you can see. She's very concerned with my hand, although she is the one that lets me handle her the most. She will just let me pick her up without a care in the world, move her however I wish. She's just like a snake, and she'll even clean her little antenna while I pick her up, which shows me I'm not afraid. She's just very cautious. That's what millipedes are. They're very cautious little creatures. They'll mind their own business, but they're just typically cautious. She loves exploring too, and she also comes from those down south states. I love Tara. I named her Tara because one of you guys suggested Earth, and Earth was a very beautiful name. But I wanted to put a twist on it, a little spin, and since she's chocolatey like the Earth, Tara, like terrain. Or terraform. Come on, I don't know why my camera isn't focusing on her, but she's a sweetheart. She's very lightweight. Very lightweight, surprisingly. Sometimes my millipedes can be pretty heavy, but she just basically is like a big old scratchy noodle. She's like a spaghetti, but do not eat her. Oh, I have my big grump over here. Cedar, all of my African millipedes are grumpy. I have had one before named Socks. He was a grump. Me and my partner used to joke around, make a voice for him that went, "No, don't touch me. You terrible human, no." And it was very, very funny. But I'm trying to see if he'll uncoil on his own here. Because he is beautiful and massive. And these African millipedes have the potential to grow to about 14, 15 inches if you let them. And all millipedes can live to up to 10 years around, 7 to 10 years in captivity if they are treated correctly. So, these are easy commitment, but lifetime commitment of a cat, basically, or close to that of a cat. Close to that of a cat or small dog. I just spritzed their enclosure to keep the moisture in. Their substrate was getting rather dry, so he has a lot of dirt stuck to him. But I think he's gonna uncurl. Are you gonna uncurl, buddy? Yeah. Are you not gonna be shy anymore? He is a beautiful sight to see. His name is Cedar. And yeah, millipedes are very slow creatures. Very cautious, like I said. Very slow and cautious. Very mindful. Very mindful. He's feeling me with all of his little toes. He's like, "Okay, is this safe? Is this gonna be safe for me? Let me see that face. Let me see that millipede face. Are you gonna hide your millipede face?" He wants to hide his millipede face from the camera. You little camera shy buddy. I think someone's a little camera shy. Do you want to look this way, Cedar? Please? Yes. Don't mind all the dirt on him. He's trying to feel with his backside if there's anywhere to escape. He's like, "No, don't touch me, you gross human." Don't mind all of, they are beautiful when there is not dirt all over them. Hey, little buddy. They're just very mindful creatures. That's part of the reason why I love them so much. They love exploring. They're very mindful. They think they found a new highway every time they find a corner that they can crawl up. It's like, Tara, too, here is like, "Ooh, a new corner? Oh, there you go. There you go. Show us your beautiful antenna." Yes, I call him my Arthropleura. Arthropleura was a dinosaur that was a millipede. He's very scared when I take him off of my hand, though, so I have to be very slow. Arthropleura was a giant, like multi-feet long millipede back in the day. And this is one of the largest millipedes that's on the planet. So I call him my Arthropleura. Oh, did you just fall? They climb up so tall that they'll fall down. It's both concerning, but I can't help but laugh at it sometimes. They're not gonna hurt themselves in here, depending on your situation. These two little reddish brown stripey guys are my American millipedes. These actually live on the East Coast where I live, so I can just go outside and find them myself. They are incredible. These, though, survive through the winter by warming themselves up inside logs. So it is normal for them, like little goose here, to want to go and dig. They have that little orange duck bill looking stripe on their heads. So I call them little geese. So he's my little goose, and that's Mama Goose. And they just like to dig. I don't see them unless it's nighttime. At night, since they're nocturnal, they come up and they explore and they eat. But that is the time that I am sleeping, so I don't normally see them. So this is their time to sleep, so they get to go back underground where they're happy. Is that right, Mama Goose? Definitely, little goose agrees. Look at the little pile of millipedes in the corner. wow, they're meeting each other again. They like to meet each other over and over again. Like, who are you? Clementine's being a little aerobics master over here. And I have more millipedes that I can't find. Like Carrot Sprout, she is my smoky oak millipede. I have, you saw a little goose. I have, and their actual names are Acorn and Gooseberry, but I call them Mama Goose and Little Goose because of the little goose stripe that's orange. Don't mind all the dirt on my hands, you know, millipede keeping and all. I have Carrot Sprout, my smoky oak. We never see her. I never see her again. She never comes up to even eat. She might be in some kind of molting process for months. I'm not sure. But maybe we'll see Carrot Sprout one day again. And then we have Woodruffy, my little blue Philippine millipede. He's just a baby. He's this little tiny little silver gray blue. He is adorable. I love little Woodruffy. I see him maybe once a week. The first thing that I want to do is give them back their rug. Their beautiful, beautiful rug here. Shake off all the dirt. We don't want dirt on it. It helps me see them more when they climb on it and walk on it, but it also allows them to have the choice to go under it. So if they want to bury themselves, they still can. That is very important to them, making sure that they have lots of soil that they can climb in. So there's their little rug, and they can enjoy climbing on top of that. And see, I can see Miss Tara over there, Mrs. Little Kisses over there, climbing on top. And that's really, really cute. And I'm gonna put their little house on it. They actually do use a tiny little hamster house. I also like giving them something to climb on because they're very noisy at night when they go to try and explore and fall and clank and everything. So giving them enough stuff to do at night when they're more active is very important, or else you'll hear thunk, thunk, thunk all night long for them trying to explore and escape. Oh wow! Look at her already playing on it! That's so cute! I also like to give them little things to climb on in the corners, such as this. Give them little wooden discs to climb on. All of this was part of a hamster set, hamster treehouse. And look, you can even reach the top of it, ma'am. That is not good. No plotting an escape. See, she'll just let me take her right back down. There you go. So sorry, ma'am. There you go. They're so cute and curious. Curious, but cautious, like I said, very cautious. Aww, look at her. You wanna go try to find your house, buddy? Maybe? No, it's not this way. It's this way. Let's see. I know he wants that. He wants that so bad. He's feeling around with his antennas. No, it's not that way. You gotta go straight. We'll see if he eventually finds it. He's just gonna go exploring for a moment. Who can get into the little crack first? Who can squeeze in there? Miss Clementine? No, not even Miss Clementine can squeeze through that crack. Poor Cedar. He's so defeated. You know, the African millipedes, they just look defeated all the time. I think it's so funny. He chases his tail sometimes. It's the weirdest thing. Is that your housey? I think that's his housey. I think he likes his housey. Let's see in there. Oh yes, he does. Very, very much. And we will not see him again all day long because he will just be sleeping in there. Nice where it's dark and nice where it's soft. I love giving them little hides like this. It's just something so pleasurable to watch them enjoy. I really love that. And sometimes all three of them, the topsoil ones, will all congregate in there and have a good time. It's the funniest thing watching them climb and explore what you put in their enclosure. And lastly, they get their little treat of banana. I feed them different things throughout the day, throughout the week. I also give them protein, but it's also important sometimes to give them a little dish of water because I find that mine really do enjoy drinking straight from the water. But right now, they have lots of condensation on the side of their enclosure, which you can probably see right here and everywhere. And my African giant millipede does drink from the sides of the enclosure sometimes. Well, this concludes a little house cleaning for the millipedes, and we will never see them again, except for the two desert millipedes, which never go out of sight. Never out of sight, never out of mind. That's why I really love them. They're actually one of the cheapest that you can get, are the chocolate and gold millipedes, and I honestly think they're the coolest looking. I mean, look at that. That is a full-on snake, if you think about it. Vegetarian snake. Wow. I hope you enjoyed, and I hope you learned something about giant millipedes today. And if you did, feel free to leave a comment, like, and subscribe so that other people who might be interested in the content can also see it and enjoy it. It helps me out with my journey on YouTube so much, and you guys just watching my videos makes all of the difference. So thank you guys from the bottom of my heart for watching this cute little pet video. I hope to see you guys soon, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye! Thank you so much for watching. Your support brings me great lengths. You can consider taking a look at my Etsy shop at misswillowartistry.com. That's the best way to support me continuing to craft. I update frequently and have a lot of fun doing so. Have a magical day!